please, for everybody to silence their cell phones. And also, please refrain from taking photos during the ceremony. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Please rise. Into her new life and gives their blessing to this marriage. Thank you. As those who love Anissa and Edward gather together, our thoughts turn to those very special people who will always be an inspiration and be present in Edward and Anissa's hearts. We know that their love and devotion to this couple served to strengthen this ceremony, and that Anissa and Edward are being embraced by them throughout. Today represents not only the joining of Edward and Anissa, but also the blending of family and friends. Anissa and Edward would also like to recognize their parents on this occasion. They are forever grateful for the love and the care their parents showed raising them. Parents, the unconditional love and support that you have continually offered have inspired Anissa and Edward to become who they are today. And they thank you from the bottom of their hearts, because without you, this day would not be possible. We'd also like to mention that Anissa and Edward's parents share over 60 years of marriage, testimony to the vows that Edward and Anissa are making this day. Parents, you are a wonderful role model for your children and for all of us present. We are gathered here in the presence of God, family, and friends to celebrate the joining together of two hearts and two lives. Anissa and Edward are glad you're here and welcome you on this absolutely beautiful evening to be witness to their special day. Just as you have been an instrumental part of their lives thus far, you will continue to participate in their future together as husband and wife. When I first met with Anissa and Edward, they told me that they met at work 6 years ago. Edward told me that he and Anissa would have probably gotten together sooner, but that because they worked in different divisions, it ended up taking a whole year for him to ask her out. They are so happy to finally share this wonderful day with all of you. Anissa, Edward, this commitment is not to be entered into lightly, but with certainty, mutual respect, and eternal love. Your willingness to accept each other's strengths and weaknesses with understanding and respect will create the foundation for a strong and lasting marriage.
share your thoughts, experiences, and dreams with one another. Cherish the intimacy and understanding that comes with marriage.
As you enter this union, your belief that marriage is a partnership between equal individuals with common goals, hopes, and dreams will give your lives together special meaning and fulfillment. May the love and friendship with which you join hearts and hands today never fail, but grow deeper with every year you spend together. May the love that you have give you strength. May the life that you share bring you joy. May the dreams that you dream bring you hope. And may the beliefs that you have bring you peace. May your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitement that marriage will bring, and may life grant you patience, tolerance, and understanding. A poem by Wilfred A. Peterson, The Art of Marriage. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. And it is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue all through the years. Marriage is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together, facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for one another, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. Marriage is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in one another. However, it is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner, and it is discovering what marriage can be at its best. Anissa, Edward, the vows which you are about to exchange serve as verbal representation of the love you pledge to one another. For it is not the words you speak today which will bond you together as one, but an inner sense of love and commitment that each of you feel within your souls. May I have the rings, please? I hold in my hand two rings to be given and received as bonds of never-ending love and devoted friendship, circles of light and circles of love, eternal and everlasting. For thousands of years, couples have exchanged rings as tokens of their vows to one another. These rings are not of great value in themselves, but are only made precious by your wearing of them. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to be bound together. Love is a circle of happiness, of wonder, and of delight. Edward, you take Anissa to be your wedded wife. Please repeat after me. I, Edward, do give myself to you, Anissa, on this our wedding day. I will cherish our friendship and love you today, tomorrow, and forever. I will trust and respect you. I will love you faithfully. Through the good times and the hard times, in sickness and in health, what may come, I will always be there. as I've given you my hands to hold, so I give you my heart to keep. As I place this ring on your finger, may it always remind you of my never-ending love. Wear this ring with joy, for your love has made me complete. Anissa, do you take Edward to be your wedded husband? I, Anissa, do give myself to you, Edward, on this our wedding day. I will cherish our friendship and love you today, tomorrow, and forever. I will trust and respect you. I will love you faithfully through the good times and the hard times, in sickness and in health. What may come, I will always be there. As I've given you my hands to hold, so I give you my heart to keep. As I place this ring on your finger, may it always remind you of my never-ending love. Wear this ring with joy, for your love has made me complete. May these rings on your fingers symbolize to you and all who know you the vows of marriage you have made here this day. At this special moment, the bride and groom will share some thoughts with us.
Those eyes that look at me now, that's arrived 5 years ago, I couldn't stop thinking about them. The way he looked at me, the way they lit up when he smiled and when he laughed. It made me make a conscious decision to make you smile and laugh as much as I can. Nothing could make me forget about those eyes until I met your heart. Who stole me away from your eyes? I honestly never believed in love. With all honesty, love was just a fantasy made to sell movies and music. But I stand here today with an open heart that clearly says I love you. You changed me not simply by your eyes and your heart and your organizational skills, but by your dedication, your love, and the beautiful children that we had together, Madison Lyanda Vasquez and Autumn Annalyn Vasquez. Although I now believe in love, the meaning of love cannot describe the connection and emotion I feel for you. You are the love of my life, the mother of our children, and the greatest person I have ever met. We already started spending the rest of our lives together. So I ask you this, let's just keep going until forever.
Being overly emotional or jealous. Thank you for being ridiculously observant and always making sure I am in a positive place. But most importantly, thank you for being such an amazing father to our two girls. Our bond goes beyond the emotional aspect of love. We both have a logical understanding of what we mean to each other and how much our relationship is, not only to us, but to our daughters. With that comes a set of promises. I promise to not let our relationship go stale. There will be date nights and time spent together for us to continue to appreciate the bond that we have above and before everything else, which is the foundation of our family. We will continue the tradition of our annual love letter ceremony each anniversary. I promise to always make an attempt to look at the bigger picture and not only the moments before I get upset. I will listen and focus on understanding the purpose and not only the first day I saw you is engraved in my memory. I was not prepared for the life that we soon follow. The level of happiness I feel seems unimaginable at points where at times I don't know how to respond to it. So I ask myself a million what ifs and freak myself out. Then the little calm voice in my head asks, what if you just relax and learn to let go of it? And this is just my final promise to you, to embrace the happiness I feel and show you and our girls how much I love you each and every opportunity comes.
Anissa and Edward. Dear God, our hearts are filled with great happiness when Edward and Anissa's wedding day, as they have pledged their vows to one another that they may risk the joys and sorrows of love. We hope that they will have a deep and loving friendship that they may forever cherish, honor, uphold, and sustain one another. Amen. This ceremony is doubly blessed, for it brings two beautiful daughters into the marriage. Madison and Autumn, share in your dreams for a life filled with much love and happiness. May they continue to be a source of love, pride, joy, and fulfillment for you both today and for always. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love is always supportive and never judgmental, for true love never fails. Wine is a symbol of joy, of the richness of life and the sweetness of love. Just as the fruit of the vine grows, nurtures, and bears fruit, it also signifies that your love will grow and ripen with every passing day. It is appropriate, therefore, that on this happy occasion, you toast life with this ancient symbol. As you share from this cup, so may you draw contentment, comfort, and happiness from your own cup of life. May you find life's joys heightened, its bitterness sweetened, and all things hallowed by true companionship, true understanding, and true love. Anissa and Edward have chosen to have a love letter and wine box ceremony. There's a box behind us that contains a bottle of wine, one sentimental to the bride and the groom, as well as a love letter written by each of them, addressed to the other. The letters are sealed, but they likely contain their deepest feelings for one another. They have created their own romantic time capsule to be opened on their first anniversary. 1 year from today, open the box, share some wine, and read one another your letters. By reading these letters, you will reflect upon the reasons you fell in love and chose to marry one another. Keep this box prominently displayed as a constant reminder of your commitment to one another. You can always, after each anniversary, write new love letters, put in another bottle of wine, and have that to look forward to opening on the celebration of your second anniversary, and the same year after year. Anissa and Edward, these are the hands of your best friend, strong and vibrant with love. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. As you laugh and cry, and as you share your innermost secrets and dreams, these are the hands that will love and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. May you always support your dreams, because as a team, everything you work for can come true. Comfort each other, hold one another tight, and always and most importantly be one another's best friend. May the home you create be a shelter against storms, a haven of peace, and a stronghold of love. May the sun shine upon you. May the moon move the tide with grace. May your hearts be warm, and may every day be filled with joy. May you endlessly delight in one another's company, and may you fulfill one another always. It is with great pleasure that those of us present can share these most significant moments with you. As you have just pledged your vows to one another, let me remind you that a marriage is a union of two lives, two hearts that beat as one, together and forever. Therefore, in accordance with the laws of the state of Florida, I do hereby pronounce you husband and wife. Edward, you may now kiss this gorgeous bride.
Tickets, and you'll be owning all the fines. Come on, skinny love, what happened here? Suckle on the hope of life was here. My, 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 my. sudden load is so slow on the spit. And I told you to be patient, and I told you to be fine, and I told you to be balanced, and I told you to be kind. And now all your love is wasted. Well then who the hell was I? 'Cause now I'm breaking out the bridges, and the end of all your